Welcome everyone. I am Sudhata Barik from National Law University, Odisha. I'll be discussing on Consumer Rights and Right to Information Act. So we have already discussed in the previous videos about who is a consumer, what is the commercial purpose, what is the consumer dispute, complaint, complainant. So we'll be now dealing with the major portion or an important portion of the Consumer Protection Act, that is defect in goods and deficiency in services. Now, how you will consider in a good that there is a defect or in a services that there is a deficiency in services? Now, that has to be decided before you file a consumer case. Now, the defect is already mentioned or it is already provided under the definition of under the Act, Consumer Protection Act, the definition of defect, where it says that if in a product there is any fault, imperfection, shortcoming in any product, quality or quantity, potency, purity and standard that is not maintained by law or by any other law or under any contract or is claimed by the trader or the manufacturer. Defect means if there is any fault or imperfection or the quality is not maintained or the quantity is not maintained that is already prescribed by any general law, then in that case a consumer can file a complaint relating the cause will be defect in the goods. Now, if any other law, like for example, Bureau of Standards or Drugs Control Act, Essential Commodities Act, there are special acts are there where the commodities or the items are decided according to the special acts. Now, if that is not maintained, again, the consumer can file a defect in good petition or complaint before the consumer forum, or if the trader or manufacturer with the purchaser is entering into a contract. Like suppose for example the manufacturer between the purchaser and the manufacturer, a contract is entered into to supply 50 kgs of rice. But when the manufacturer or the trader is delivering the commodity, it is found that 30 kgs or 35 kgs has been delivered, the 15 kgs are not delivered. Then again it comes, again the dispute or the defect arises in the goods. So again that is another thing that has to be decided, another thing where the defect can arise between the manufacturer and the consumer. The last one is as it is claimed by the trader. Now you can find it with the definition, you can relate it to the transcript, the complete definition, as it is claimed by the trader or the manufacturer. For example, if it is claimed, for example, that in malls you must have come across with the discount that is offered, that 50% discount, buy one get one free. If it is claimed by a manufacturer and that is again not provided to the consumer, so again a defect there arises relating to fault or imperfection, or you can say potency, shortcoming, whatever, whichever term is applicable under the definition of defect. On the basis of that, alleging that, you can file a consumer case before the consumer forum. Now relief, now we'll come to directly to the relief granted. Now again, one thing, the consumer court will first hand, the consumer court will not directly give a compensation to the consumer. First, he has to verify the case. Now, verify first, we have already discussed that whether there is a consumer dispute or not, that has to be decided by the court first. Now, once it is decided there is a consumer dispute, then the relief issue comes here. Now, in the relief issue, the court will first try to remove the defect in the product or deficiency in services. Then he will come to the replacement of the product. Then the second step, he will return the money to the consumer. Now, if these three things are not satisfied, the forum or the consumer is not satisfied with this, then the last one that can be taken up by the court is the compensation. Now, how the compensation has to be decided? As we know, if it is a consumer protection is a special act and the compensation is the foremost thing that under Consumer Protection Act that is provided. So, that is the last one where the court will give a compensation for not providing satisfied or satisfactory services to a consumer. Now, again, the second thing is the burden of proof to prove the defect or deficiency in services is on the consumer. Again, the consumer has to clarify that he has purchased, he has suffered a defect in good or a deficiency in services. services. So it is definitely on the part of the consumer to prove his case. Again, another issue comes here about the intention. Now, under Consumer Protection Act, the intention is irrelevant. Intention doesn't play any role in the Consumer Protection Act. Whether the manufacturer has or the consumer has or the trader has, the intention doesn't play any role under Consumer Protection Act. So, second thing is the joint and several liability of the manufacturer. To understand joint and several liability, I'll discuss a case of Jose Philip Mafilil. So, in that case, what happened? The manufacturer and trader both are liable for delivering a defect in the car that they have provided to the customer, where the liability is both on the dealer and the manufacturer. So that is where the joint and several liability is also one of the part of the relief granted to the consumers. Second is the deficiency in services. Now, deficiency in services is again given in many services, like in banking sector, airline services, courier services, educational services, electricity services, and medical services. Now, again, I have briefly mentioned about the medical negligence cases, where you can find a landmark case of Indian Medical Association versus VP Santa, where the Supreme Court has held that the liability of the doctor and the hospital management arises when a patient is admitted. So the standard duty of care and skill that has to be maintained in a hospital. So that again, the consumer, when a patient is admitted, he is also considered as a consumer. So he can file a case before the Consumer Protection Act 1986. So that is all about the medical negligence or cases are also coming under the deficiency in services. Then I'll directly come to the pecuniary jurisdiction. Now, under the Consumer Protection Act, the forum is divided into three, that is the district level, state level, and the national commission. District level, now how the pecuniary jurisdiction has been divided. Now, if a claim or the compensation that is claimed is within 20 lakhs, then the consumer can file a complaint before the district forum. If the consumer filed a complaint whose compensation amount is more than 1 crore, then he can file a complaint in the state forum. And if it is more than 1 crore, then the consumer can file a complaint in the national forum. So all these forums have the same power that is already given to the civil courts, like cross-examinations, examination in the laboratory, survey, testing, all the powers has been given, and all the forums have given appeal provision. For example, if a consumer is not satisfied or if a complainant is not satisfied with the order of the district forum, then he can appeal to the state forum, and if he is not satisfied with the state forum, then he can apply to the national commission, and if he is not satisfied with the decision of the national commission, then he can approach to the Supreme Court. But again, one thing is important: a consumer can't directly file an application before the Supreme Court, which is already decided by the Supreme Court. It has to go from the district court, district commission, then state commission, then the national commission. After that, if a complainant is not satisfied with the decision of the national commission, then it will go to the before the Supreme Court. Another important contemporary area under Consumer Protection Act is the e-commerce. Now, e-commerce is not specifically mentioned under the Consumer Protection Act 1986, but they have provision in the new Consumer Protection Bill. But e-commerce, again, it is regulated by the Consumer Protection Act, having the same provision that will be applicable in defect in goods and deficiency in services. Already, the e-contracts has been guided by Section 10A of IT Act, Information Technology Act, but as we know, under e-commerce, acceptance, proposal and acceptance has been made, and it is already guided by the Consumer Protection Act and Contract Act. So consumer, so the online services that is offered to the consumer, again it is regulated by the Consumer Protection Act 1986, where if there is any deficiency in services in online transactions or online shopping or online e-commerce transaction or e-commerce activities, then they can file an complaint before the forum under Consumer Protection Act 1986 also. So this is all about the Consumer Protection Act 1986, the important provisions, decided cases and illustrations. You can go through that transcript, and you are free to ask any questions relating to that. Thank you.